Ευχαριστήσω με τις Zara Waters.
Does anyone have a question?
Κάποια ερώτηση, κάποιο σχόλιο.
Το strap λέει το έχει όντως.
The strap was it? Did it actually exist in the Victorian?
Yeah, they did. I have a picture, a lovely naughty postcard from, I guess, the 1890s of two women using a strap-on dildo.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, it's a piece of pornography, of course, the image. And I guess it's hard to say how much they were used, how widely they were used, but they certainly existed. Not quite like that. I think that was something from my own imagination, but sort of solid like that. But yeah, they were definitely around.
Ναι, υπήρχαν. Έχει και μια φωτογραφία στο αρχείο της, πορνογραφική όμως, γύρω με την ημερομηνία 1890. Δεν χρησιμοποιόταν Εβραίος, αλλά ναι, όντως υπήρχε τελικά.
Πώς οι κριτικές σας στο Αγγλία, πώς δεχτήκαν αυτή την ταινία στη τηλεόραση, ας πούμε, στη κρατική τηλεόραση δεν επέκτησαν καλά, στο BBC. Γενικά, πώς ήταν η αποδοχή?
What was the reception of the film? Was it positive comments, negative?
It was very positive. There was a lot of anticipation before it was screened because there was a lot of media interest in it. That, to be honest, the BBC and Andrew Davis, the scriptwriter, really played up to get advance publicity for it. So there was a lot of news. There was some mad newspaper interest, like the Sun newspaper, which is the sort of worst kind of British tabloid. For the second episode, the one that had the dildo, the episode clashed with a football match. So the Sun gave the exact time that you could turn over the channel from the football match to catch the dildo scenes and then to just go back to the football match. Kind of, you know, aiming it at men, of course. But that didn't bother me because I felt that I felt that lesbians were. I felt that the show didn't exclude lesbians. That would have bothered me if that had happened. And it seemed to me that it welcomed all sorts of viewers, and I liked that about it.
Ήταν θετικά τα σχόλια. Βέβαια, είχε πολύ media interest από τις εφημερίδες που είχαν ξεκινήσει και ειδικότερα από μια εφημερίδα, η Espresso, ας πούμε, της Ελλάδος, η Sun, που έγραφε συγκεκριμένα πότε, επειδή έπεσε η προβολή της σειράς μαζί με ένα μεγάλο ποδοσφαιρικό αγώνα, έγραφε πότε θα μπορούσε να αλλάξει το κανάλι σου, να πετύχει στο δίλητο και πότε να συνεχίσει μετά να δεις τον υπόλοιπο αγώνα. Αλλά της άρεσε πολύ ότι δεν απέκλειε καθόλου τις λεσβίες και ότι ήταν ανοιχτό σε ένα ευρύτερο κοινό.
Was this film based on a true story, and what was the source of inspiration for
him? I'd love to be able to say, you know, it was all true, and there were lots of lesbians in the musical and lots of lesbian clubs and bars, but of course it wasn't quite as extensive as I've portrayed it, but I used as much information as I could find. So my real starting point was actually cross-dressing in the music hall, which was a big part of musical entertainment, mainstream musical entertainment, and obviously very heterosexually presented. But when we look at those images, the women looked like lesbians, they looked like drag kings. And I think for some viewers at the time, they probably had an erotic charge. They had some of the big stars had lots of female fans, you know, who would write them really passionate letters. So that was one starting point for me.
Όχι, δεν ήταν βασισμένο σε ιστορία. Μακάρι να μπορούσε να πει ότι υπήρχαν πολλές λεσβίες και πολλά λεσβιακά μπάρ εκείνη την περίοδο, αλλά το σημείο εκείνης της ιστορίας ήταν το cross-dressing που υπήρχε εκεί τότε, σε musicals και σε διάφορα. And sorry.
Yeah, so as I say, I just looked for any sort of source I could for lesbian history. So, you know, that we know that women had strong networks when politically in the suffrage movement or in socialism. There were very strong friendship networks between women, and some of them became romantic partnerships. We know that some women cross-dressed on the street and passed as men. You know, that might have had a lesbian element to it. And really, I just kind of used my imagination as well to fill in the gaps of lesbian history the way I'd like it to be, I suppose.
Καθώς έκανε το research για τη λεσβιακή ιστορία βασικά, βρήκε ότι είχαν δημιουργηθεί πολλές ερωτικές φιλίες, ειδικά μεταξύ των γυναικών που ήταν σοσιαλίστες ή γενικότερα που είχαν μπει στο προσκήνιο, που είχαν ένα ηγετικό ρόλο, αλλά κυρίως το είχε επινοήσει, δηλαδή όλες αυτές τις λεσβιακές ιστορίες, το πώς θα ήθελε να ήταν εκείνη την περίοδο.
I think in this festival that you're also showing the Ann Lister, the film about Ann Lister, which is which is completely based on real diaries from much, much earlier than this, from the early part of the 19th century, and that shows a sort of wealthy woman having numerous affairs with other women and finding it very easy to make lovers, you know, to meet new women and have sex with them. I mean, it was obviously happening for some women. It's just it's rather hard to find the information.
Στο φεστιβάλ κάναμε και την προβολή των μυστικών ημερολογιών της Ann Lister, που είναι όντως βασισμένος στην πραγματική ιστορία. Και μέσα σε αυτή την ιστορία πραγματικά βλέπουμε ότι η γυναίκα αυτή έβρισκε ερωμένες, απλά είναι πολύ δύσκολο να βρει, να συλλέξει κάποιες παραπάνω πληροφορίες για αυτή την περίοδο.
Yes.
I want to add something. It was easy for her because she was very rich and independent.
Yes, oh, absolutely. Yes. And certainly, I mean, when I was looking for models for the late 19th century, there were much more for men. You know, there were rich men like Oscar Wilde, who had the money and the leisure to have lots of sex, you know, with rent boys. And if you come into the early 20th century in Paris, you know, there were people like Natalie Barney and René Vivien, who again, very rich women, whose money allowed them to have very extravagant lesbian lives. So I thought, well, you know, if they were doing it in the 1920s, I could imagine other wealthy women doing it in London in the 1890s, you know.
Πάλι όσο κάνει την ερευνά της, έπισε ότι κυρίως άντρες ήταν οι πλούσιοι άντρες που είχαν αυτή τη ζωή γεμάτη σεξ, αλλά είχε βρει ότι και στο Παρίσι η Natalie Barney και η Ρόνια Βίβιαν έζησαν παρόμοιες ζωές. Και αυτό ήταν την περίοδο του 1920, οπότε γιατί να γίνονταν και νωρίτερα στην Αγγλία.
And of course that doesn't mean that working class women weren't also having romances and sexual relationships. It's just that inevitably working class women leave less of a historical record, so it's harder. You have to work harder to find information about them.
Και αυτό δεν σημαίνει ότι αποκλείει τις γυναίκες της εργατικής τάξης που είχαν τέτοιες σχέσεις, αλλά απλά δεν υπάρχει κάποιο ντοκουμέντο στο οποίο θα μπορούσε να βρει και να το πάρει για το δείξει μέσα των ταινιών της. Λοιπόν, αύριο είναι η παρουσίαση στις 7 στην αίθουσα 2 και η προβολή του Fingersmith, οπότε ελπίζω να μας θυμίσετε και τότε. Thank you.